It's a really tough world for a overprotective dad. After the speech from Jeff yesterday, I'm really frightened about Instagram and stuff. I hope it all dies with before my daughter becomes a teenager. But getting back to the topic in place, I just want to check: do we have any representatives of agile consultancies here? Somewhere in the front. I don't see much in the back. Great, special welcome for you guys. I'll come back to you in a moment. But before I go there, I got to set one thing straight. When we talk about ING Bank in Poland, we're not doing any kind of transformation, any kind of big bang change, revolution in our bank right now. And why I say that? Because from our perspective, transformation is something that you need when things go wrong. So you've got to save yourself, you've got to do something rapidly, then you have some casualties on the way, probably. We don't want that. We want a stable and sustainable business. So we're not doing transformation. But still, we see the world is changing, so we need to find ways to satisfy our customers in a better way. Because traditional hierarchical ways are not cutting it anymore. So here comes agility with empowered teams, self-organizing teams with different roles, different roles of a leader. And we want to get there, but through evolution, through continuous improvement, not changing everything at once. Because we see it as a way of maintaining efficiency and stability. So we want to change a lot, quickly, but in small portions, not to destroy our working business model right now. And in order to support our organization in best possible way, one of the things that we did is that we created an Agile coach team, internal Agile coaches. Some of them are sitting somewhere here supporting me right now. So there are 15 of us around, and while we were building this team, we focused on four main things. So first one is diversity. So we really looked for people from all kinds of backgrounds. So we have people from IT, obviously, but also HR, trainings, retail banking, project management, both from ING and some other companies. Because this way, we created like an endless source of inspiration for ourselves. So this huge variety of knowledge that we can use all the time, which is great. And when we add to that mix a huge effort and huge focus on teamwork, you get something great, because when you don't have competition within your team, when you have strong focus on learning from each other, when you have a true team spirit and thriving on success of each other, then you have a great place to work. That's for us personally really important. And then, and also a great results, because we can tackle a wide variety of problems, of topics within the team. And finally, the last component of our team is the organization know-how. So getting to know our bank very well, so we understand how it's working right now. Because then we take all that mix into action. And we focus on three things working with our organization. The first one is strong partnership. So we really want to know the nature of their business. We really want to understand the strategy of ING. We really want to know what they want to achieve. And in that way, building partnerships, we can easily find solutions that fits them best. It's easier to convince to try new ideas when you have good partnerships. So we really work on that a lot. Second thing is that we really focus on looking at the whole organization level. So our intention is not only to change, for example, IT department, to introduce Scrum there. We're thinking about all kinds of connections, all relationships within the company to make something that would work for everybody. And that obviously means that we really need to focus on consistency, on creating a common language for the whole organization. Because it makes the learning process a little bit easier. Quicker. It reduces complexity when you talk the same language in all areas of the bank. So it really helps us out because like 3 years ago when we built this team, we're talking probably about supporting around 600 people. Now it's close to 1,500. And it's going to be probably around 3,000 or more next year. So supporting the teams on this kind of agility, this our own agility, that's the way we've chosen to do it. Keeping the continuous improvement and continuous evolution way of doing things.
So last thing that you mentioned was consistency, yes? And yes, it is good to have a common language also. Example of Microsoft provides it. At the same time, it took a lot of time to get any kind of agreement. We have to speak about everything with everyone sometimes to actually agree on things that we further align. Also, you mentioned partnership. And I agree that it is important to have people that actually want to listen to you. And maybe when they listen, they want to change. However, from time to time, we get so much, we are so much with the teams and with the people that we are stop being objective. And we also are less challenging for them. And even we might defend some kind of imperfections or some other things. So it's not so great as you say. And also about teamwork. And before I go there, I have to say and agree that this team is absolutely amazing. And I'm not saying that only because the large part of the team is here in this room, but it's actually true. So regarding teamwork, I feel sometimes that with this teamwork, inspiration, etc., we might be a little bit too much believing in our awesomeness. Yes, that we are so great, that we are doing this stuff in the best way that we can do. And also you mentioned inspiration. There's a lot of it. We have a separate Slack channel. However, it's sometimes also a little bit ING flavored. So we inspire each other, but it might be a little bit hermetic. So what do you think about it?
Yeah, honestly, I cannot deny what you're saying. But still, from the perspective of the evolution we want to pursue, that's the model we've chosen. But again, we're looking for ways to improve it. And as you may have suspected from the topic, the matter is in working with external consultancies, with cooperating with you guys, because you're the ones sitting here in front row that can provide us with a fresh look. So when we are so focused on ING way of doing things, you're the ones that show us the mirror and tell us, yeah, there's where you are, in fact. So look at that. Then you are the ones that help us challenge those solutions. There are ING flavor tainted solutions. You're the inspiration to look for other sources of knowledge, to look for inspiration from other companies. So that's the mix. That's the mix we're working with. Thank you, guys.
So our presentation has a topic, choose your weapon. And we also have to make one thing straight, that actually no weapon is required, because there is no war, no enemy, and nothing to be won or lost. What we would like to what kind of a message we would like to leave you with is that choose your own way, because we don't have a simple prescription what to do. We don't have any ready answers. The story that we have is that if you are looking for a continuous evolutionary change that Carol mentioned at the beginning, this kind of a model works for us. That we've got an internal agile coach team supported a little bit with external consultants. But what will work for you, only you can answer. So thank you very much for your time. Thank you all external agile consultants that we are working with that provide this kind of fresh looks and other things. And yeah, thank you very much.
That's it. Thank you.